Triple the ones. One times one equals 111. Here's something you gotta learn. The older you get, the more you're gonna realize. Shit, I wish I was back in high school. The whole time you're in high school, you're saying to yourself, man, I can't wait to get out of here. I'm never, ever going to wish I would come back. Because you hear your parents say stuff like, oh, I would do anything to go back to high school. If I didn't have to work and just go to high school, I would do that. And then you would look at your parents like, are you fucking insane? That's what you do. Unless you really like school, but I'm talking average teenager in high school. That's what you're thinking. You have no fucking idea what the real world is like. And you get out there, and then it's just like, ba-bow, here it is. You take it, and that's it. You gotta deal with it. And you don't realize this in high school. You really don't. Unless you're like one of those kids that are super independent and didn't have any parents, had to do everything on their own, then you get a good experience of what it's like. But for the majority of children, that, you know, you don't get to understand what the fuck life is. You just don't. You have no fucking idea. And I was just thinking about this today, because again, I'm having a shitty day. But I'm learning. I'm learning how to block it when I have to do this. Even when I'm doing the research for this podcast, it calms me and soothes me. And it's like, you're getting stuff done. All right? This is turning into like, I don't know, I don't want to call it a job, because that word relates so negatively with what it should be, so I don't want to use that word. This is, you know, it's just like, this is what I do, you know, and I'm comfortable in it now. It's a good spot. I'm getting shit figured out finally. It's still not perfected yet, and I don't think it ever will be. I'm constantly revamping and figuring new stuff out. Yeah, so I don't want to make this episode go on too long. These are chopsticks, by the way, because it's kind of late and I gotta get up early. But yes, I had a garbage day all day today, and I was unsure if I was gonna be able to film this, but I am able to. Here's today's card. It's tradition around here to show you the card. It's not tradition to show you what's on the card, but you'll find out because I'll talk about it. And there's only one topic on here, but we can, it's a big one. I'm thinking of doing something, you know, this is kind of what I wanted to do with the podcast for a while, is really make it like YouTube orientated. YouTube. I want it to be kind of centered around YouTube. I mean, it's on YouTube, but I like discussing YouTube because that's really one of the only things I know quite well, because I've literally been on it and been a part of it since the dawn of its existence. That's something I really want to portray. I don't know. I feel like it's important. Not like, I'm not saying being on YouTube is important. I'm saying it's important for me to let my audience know that I have been around since then, so you guys don't think I'm full of shit. You know what I'm saying? Because I lived it. I was there,
young fella. I saw the hatchet.
You know what I'm saying? I was there the day it happened. Okay? And lots of people have. But lots of people haven't. Lots of people have been, you know, obviously been around since the dawn of YouTube. But nobody has been, not everyone has been involved with YouTube. Like, YouTube completely, still to this day, surrounds my life and everything that I do. I don't go a day without going on YouTube, and I haven't since it existed. I use the platform every fucking day, and I've been watching YouTubers grow and evolve, and the platform grow and evolve. I've seen it all. In terms of YouTube, I know what's going on. And so today I want to talk about Smosh. There's so much to talk about Smosh. So this is why I'm making it one episode. I'm thinking, you know, I'll have episodes here and there where I'll discuss other YouTube channels, and I don't know. Again, I'm still in the beginning stages of this bullshit. Only at episode 111. So let's,
Okay, guys, let's do some dancing. Let's show me my moves.
I'm gonna show me my moves, okay? Smosh. Where do I begin? Well, how about in the fucking beginning? Smosh created their channel in 2005. Literally when the platform was created. Smosh, this is coming from Anthony Padilla, who is one of the, you know, founders and the original founder of Smosh, really, because this guy here, he originally started Smosh as just like a website. It was a website before YouTube existed. It was a website for him and his friends to go on, and I don't remember exactly what they did. I can't remember. I don't know. It was just a website for him and his friends to fuck around on. And then YouTube came around and they started making videos. And one in particular, now you gotta remember, put yourself back in 2005. The term viral video didn't exist. Even the thought of a video, you know, having an insane amount of views wasn't even heard of. And so, you know, Smosh at the time, you know, they weren't popular right off the bat. We'll just say that. As anyone is. But what does it say here? 2006. Music video, doesn't say. Anyway. But April 28th, 2006. YouTube displayed its first most subscribed list, and Smosh was number one. So a year after they started. So they were popular pretty well right away. I was mistaken. They were number one on YouTube with guess how many subscribers. Now remember, 2006. Number one spot on YouTube. They had 2,986 subscribers. That is it. Today, if you have that many subscribers, you're nothing. You are a significant piece of shit. So imagine how I feel. I only have, I'm not even going to say, because it's a low number. But it's a number, and you got to start somewhere, right? So apparently, they gained number one on April 28th, 2006, surpassing some person named Filthy Whore. Like, it literally says on the Smosh wiki page, they surpassed someone named Filthy Whore. What? Now, I have no idea who this Filthy Whore person is. Never heard of it. Maybe it's some porn, probably. I don't know. But if it's just some guy, like, fucking around, and I was like, I'm going to make my channel name Filthy Whore, that's pretty funny. So as they progressed, they put out their, at the time, most, you know, it was, so, this is like the definition of a viral video. Almost the creation of viral video was their Pokemon theme music video. Now, I can't show it because it's, you know, copywritten music, but you might remember just by looking at this thumbnail here. These still images. This is Ian and Anthony singing the Pokemon theme. This is dumb. Look how low quality it is. That's a good place to stop. But look. This is what viral videos were. And this is what people thought of viral videos. Now, I can't find the original. I think they removed it or something. But... what was I going to say? Smosh. That's what I was going to say. If you were to look at what makes a viral video nowadays, I mean, I guess it hasn't changed really. If you think about it, I was going to say it's nothing like this, but it kind of is still like this. You can still film something in your room. You never know what's going to go viral. But this is what made them. This is what really kicked them in the arse to get them going. But then, if you're really hardcore into YouTube, or if you know a thing or two about it, you would have heard of the evolution of dance. This dude named Judson Leopoli, he took over the number one position. Surpassing Smosh because of his evolution of dance video. Now, at this time, the person who had the most subscribers had the most views as well. And that's just how it was because there was so little amount of people on the platform. Nowadays, it doesn't work like that at all. Oh, yes. So then, I think they came back at one point, but maybe not for long, because someone named, a group of vloggers named Brookers came by and took them out, and then Lonely Girl 15 was number one for a little bit. Now, Lonely Girl 15, she was one of the original vloggers, because this is when vlogging was... kind of getting its foot in the door. Not everyone was doing it. Just certain individuals were doing it. And this girl named Lonely Girl 15, who, she said her name was Bree, I think. And I think it says it in here somewhere. Yeah, Bree. But she was actually an actor who had some other name, and it wasn't genuine. So she lost subscribers after... people found out that she was a fake. Anyway, so in 2007, these are prime years we're getting into now. 2007, this is when shit was fucking really starting to go crazy. And this is when I started to realize, damn, I gotta get on this. I gotta make videos on this platform now. Anyway, so in 2007, this is probably when I discovered Smosh, too. It was in 2007. They became most subscribed again. They hit the 100,000 subscriber mark. And that was huge. That was, you know, worldwide news in terms of just the YouTube community. And when when I found out about the 100,000, I was like, oh my god. Like, that was insane. Okay? And now you look at PewDiePie, 100 million. Million! 100 million! It's crazy. It's crazy. It's crazy. It's just crazy because I lived it. And at the time, it seemed so insane to me. Like, I didn't even think that was possible. 100,000. But, so, you know, to say, you know, one day someone's going to hit 100 million. If you were to tell me that in 2007, I would have said, there's no fucking way. Of course, I was only 12 years old. I said that weird. But still, I wouldn't have believed you. So, makes me think, and I'm pretty sure I talked about this in a recent episode, but it makes me think that, you know, one of these days someone's going to hit a billion. And you know what? I can't deny that that's not going to happen. Because I would have said that about 100 million, and look what happened. So, anyway, so Smosh held that position. Then they hit 300,000, then 400,000, then 500,000. And then, so it says here Niga Higa came and took over. But I thought Fred came first, but I guess not. So Niga Higa came, swiped him out of the number one position with 1 million. There's no way fucking Fred got 1 million first, right? I don't know. I just remember Fred was the first YouTuber to get 1 million. It was either Fred or Niga Higa. Anyway. Doesn't matter. So the Fred era. God damn. There was, like, this is all in, like, 2007. 2007, 2008. Like, around that time. Fred comes around. 1 million subscribers. And then he ends up on Nickelodeon. He's all over the place, and that was like the real introduction into, you know, allowing YouTube to help you become a success in the entertainment world. And it was around then people started realizing, hey, YouTube might be taking over, or just the internet in general might be taking over at this point. Fred, this kid who just changed the pitch of his voice and ran around acting like a, I can't say that word, acting like a,
cum.
Acting like a cumtard. But I loved him. I was a big fan of Fred. It's really hard to talk about this stuff because there's so much to talk about. Let me just see here. Yeah, you know, they keep, it's like, Smosh comes in to number one, goes out of number one, Shane Dawson comes, and Smosh wipes him out, and then Machinima is number one for a while, and, you know, it goes on, and then PewDiePie just fucking dominates, and he's been dominating for fucking years now. But I even have an article here. Oh, yeah, Ray William Johnson was fucking number one at one point, and then Smosh passed them, or him. And now you don't see anything about Ray William Johnson anymore. He still does, like, podcast, I think, live stream or something, with one of the dudes from Epic Rap Battles. So anyway, Smosh, you know, keeps blowing up their brand. They changed the logo up a bit. And they used to be They used to only upload, like, sketch-type videos. They're very high quality. But they weren't that funny. To be honest, I never really found Smosh sketches funny. Like, they're funny, but they never made me laugh. They made me laugh when I was a kid, but then as I got older, I didn't find them that funny anymore. I found the acting of Anthony and Ian was too... It wasn't organic enough. It was very... Like, you could tell that they just memorized a script. And you can really tell when someone's bad at acting. And I hate to say it, and I don't want to say it. It's hard for me to say, because I'm obviously not an actor, and I don't know about the business. Maybe I shouldn't say it. I'll just say this. When I watch the Valley Folk, now don't get me wrong, I'm a huge fan of the Valley Folk. Love everything they do, love everyone on there. You know, I've been a fan since fucking, well, obviously SourceFed, but even Bratz and Beretta, I knew all about that. I mean, Steve Lee and Elliot were never really around on YouTube before SourceFed, so I didn't know about them. But anyway, with that being said, when I watch their, they do a show called Your Show, which is a show that is paid by Patreon, so they call it Your Show because it's the Patreon. Anyway, so, you know, when they do that show, they do little skits in between their segments, and the acting is not, you know, I prefer their stuff that they do sitting on the couch. When they're sitting on the couch just improvising, it's beautiful. It's so beautiful. It's funny. Like, I actually laugh extremely hard with everything they do in the couch format or in the podcast format. But when they're doing the acting little sketches in between, it's too hard to tell. Like, they're just reading a prepared script. Like, you can, like, they are acting, but it's, is the term overacting? Maybe. But you can really tell what's going on. I want to, especially Steve, like, Steve's honestly probably the worst. Steve's the funniest guy when he's not in that acting spot. Like, number one, Steve is number one, the most funniest guy out of them all. Unless he's doing, you know, the acting part. You know, because, like, Lee's actually a pretty good actor. Joe's been acting his whole, so yeah, you know, so has Lee and Elliot. They're all, like, decent. But you can still tell. Like, Joe and Steve, especially, I can tell. Well, in the mall, like, anyway, I don't want to, we're not even talking about it, we're talking about Smosh, right? What is this podcast? We're talking about Smosh? What the fuck kind of idea was that? So Smosh goes on, life goes on, they get bought out by a company called Defy Media, as really every big YouTuber eventually does. Their brand gets bought by someone, and then they lose the creative freedoms that they have. And this did not jive well with Anthony. You know, Smosh was Anthony and Ian. That was Smosh. If you say to me, still to this day, Smosh, I think Anthony and Ian, because that's they created it. They were that's all it was. They had actors in there, but it was every sketch was something that Anthony and Ian did together. And then, you know, Defy bought them, and then A bunch of other actors came in. They started making all kinds of content that relates to, you know, the algorithm, so that they get the views that way. They do, you know, they participate in all the challenges and different video styles. And Anthony didn't really, you know, feel comfortable anymore. And it was really shocking to see Anthony leave Smosh, but he did. He left Smosh. When did he leave Smosh? June 14th. 2017. I should say that. 2017. Left Smosh. He was a part of it since 2005. He created it. He literally created it. Him himself created the website in the beginning. And then just like... You hear this story so much, not only in YouTube, but in everything. The companies, you know, someone builds a company from the ground up. They're proud of it. You know, they love it in the beginning, and then it gets popular and popular, and, you know, they're still loving it. And, you know, they're making all kinds of money, and they get all kinds of fame. And then, you know, it gets to a point where these larger companies make an offer you can't refuse, and then you sell your soul to the devil. It's a story that's been told over and over again. You sell your soul, they take your shit, it's theirs, and they turn it into something that you never imagined it would ever be. And that's what happened to Smosh through Anthony's eyes. Now, okay, so that happens, and then actually a year after he left, then Defy Media announced that they were shutting down Smosh, you know, closing the whole company and firing everyone. This is exactly what happened to SourceFed. SourceFed was, you know, started through Philip DeFranco. It was just a small little news thing, and it grew into this massive thing. Discovery Network came and bought them, fired everyone, and got rid of the whole project. And it's just insane. You see this all the time. It really makes a person like myself wonder, am I going to sell my brand to some major organization only to find out that down the road they're going to cancel the Dynamite Gizmo franchise and fire everyone, including myself, from this, what I created. Like, I assume right now I'm living in the glory days. And when it gets bigger, something's gonna happen. But anyway, that happened. And luckily, Rhett and Link came to the rescue with Mythical Entertainment, because they're such a massive enterprise. They're not owned by anyone. They are independent, and they are huge. And they swooped in and said, you know what? We recognize your value, Smosh, and we are going to take you on as part of the Mythical crew. And they sucked them in. And it's great. I'm glad it happened that way. Because now they have their creative freedom back, but they don't have Anthony anymore. He's gone and done. I wish they would have brought Anthony back. Anthony and Ian, like, they fit together. It's weird to see them separated. But what do? Right? So now Smosh is nothing like it used to be. Smosh is basically like, I like to think of it as like SourceFed is a really good example. SourceFed doesn't exist anymore. The videos still exist online, but, you know, they don't focus on news necessarily, but like I guess SourceFed is not a great example. But like, I guess SourceFed had videos like what they do, where the Try Not To Be Funny challenge, where the whole crew is involved in one activity, and I actually enjoy it. I watched a lot of it yesterday. And that's what made me want to do this video. Their new stuff is... I like it. I like it. You know, sketch comedy, although it can be great, it's kind of a thing of the past now, to be honest. And so... Like, here's the people they got now. Shayne Topp, Courtney Miller, Noah Grossman, Olivia Sue, Keith Leek Jr., which is a fucking great name. Like, they're all hilarious people, literally. Like, they're great people. They're super funny people. Especially this guy. This guy is my favorite. This Noah Grossman guy. He's fucking hilarious. They're all hilarious. They're all great at improv. And that's a lot of what the show is based around now. And I love improv. I love good improv. And they're good at it. And, you know, and Ian's still a part of it, too. But it mostly focuses on those, five people I just mentioned. So, you know, in the past I would have said, what the hell, you know? What did Smosh turn itself into? But usually I long for the original stuff. Like, I don't like it when channels drastically change. But you know what? I'm starting to accept it now because I realize you have to evolve with the platform. And, you know, if it's good... then great. It doesn't always work out, but sometimes it does. I'm not going to do Reddit this episode because, well, because like I said, it's late and I got to get up early. I told myself I should have recorded this yesterday, but I wasn't supposed to have work today, so I was going to do it in the day. But I ended up having work, so, yeah. Doesn't matter. Turned out to be a shitty day anyway. So that's it for this episode of the Dynamite Gizmo podcast. I hope you enjoyed it. Please like, comment, subscribe, hit that bell notification. You know what everybody fucking says on the platform? And I hope to see you in the next one. Bye-bye. Let me just open up a new page here, a new document. And I says to myself, I will call it...
I don't know, but I've been told... Eskimo pussy is mighty cold. What? Oh no. Why the record? Oh, fuck. I guess it's gonna be audio only. Oh well. Fuck. That sucks. Forgot to hit record!